your 3D glasses on then, pussy, because you know we coming straight at you.
PPV, live this motherfucker, my big bro, Bill Collector. How are you rocking, brother?
You know, I'm maintaining, man. I'm out here just focused right now, man.
Super focused, you know what I'm saying? Super.
Yeah.
Super duper focused, you know what I'm saying? Before we start this interview, RIP to LB the Boss. You know what I'm saying? Back. Your brother. You know what I mean?
It's the boss. Along with the boss, you know what I'm saying?
Out the gate.
Bro name.
Out the gate, you know what I'm saying? So you going to carry his, like, you going to be like Bill Collector the Boss, or you just going to RIP his name?
Yeah, I'm just going to hold his name down. Like, I'm going to keep it going out. Me and bro plan for this shit to go get fucking stuff.
Ah, so y'all had a plan and, yeah, okay. Okay, I got you. I got you. You know what I'm saying? So you just flying the flag. You flying the flag right now.
That's a fact.
Salute you for that. You know what I'm saying? Salute to his family. You know what I'm saying? RIP LB the Boss. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All facts. You know what I'm saying?
Man.
Yeah, real shit. You know what I'm saying? I had to start the interview off right. You know what I mean?
Don't interview. What's up, dude? What's going on?
Nah, it's all good. You know what I'm saying? Ultimate Madness 2, bro. You know what I mean? You got, bro, it's crazy, bro. You know what I'm saying? You had Young Cannon, you know what I mean? You had B-Magic at first, you know what I mean? Then they switched it, you know what I mean? And then you still focused in on that. I want to talk about that. The switch up of opponents, and they're both punchers in their own respective right. Like, how did you switch up for that?
I had two different opponents in between them.
Oh, wow. Really?
They called me for, first it was B-Magic, then it was Danger Zone, Prep. They almost threw drugs in a mix for a rematch. Then they didn't want to do any rematches from the beginning, so they was going to do something different. Then they called me with, they asked me if I wanted to, they gave me a choice between Young Cannon, Prep, and Danger Zone. So I picked Young Cannon.
Oh, wow.
So I knew everybody would count me out.
Okay, so let me, I don't want to speak about your round, but what you were saying in your first round, I think it was your first round, you know what I mean? Like, I'm the nigga that, like, how you were saying, like, I'm not a top tier guy. I'm the nigga that can choose who he want to type of guy. I'm paraphrasing. You know what I mean?
Yeah, been here for 10 years and still hot shit. Have a major fall now with URL, never losing my spot here.
Mm-hmm, that being shit.
Being able to call Smack P, Chico, or Beasley and pick and choose from giving my shot there.
Mm. So, was that bar... So you came up with that because of that scenario? Or
I mean,
that's just normal
facts.
Shit?
I was talking facts. I'm the reason you got here. I made shit pop here when you was not here.
Mm. Okay, so I'm asking a question because, you know what I'm saying? Because some people say bars that don't really... It's factual, you know what I mean? So when I pose a question and then you answer it, then I hear, oh, damn, it might have some facts to that shit. You know what I'm saying? So,
yeah,
you the reason that... You know what I'm saying? Shout out to... First of all, shout out to Young Cannon. I just want to give a shout out to Young Cannon, first of all. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but major shout out to Young Cannon.
Out the gate, but go ahead and talk your shit, though. You know what I'm saying? That was just a, hey, man, shout out to that nigga, but you still got to talk your shit. Y'all battle rapper. You know what I mean? So,
right.
you really feel like, nigga... Nigga, it's because of me he was here. Because you really gave him the green light?
That's who I picked. I could have picked anybody, bro.
Why Young Cannon out of all the people that you named? You know what I'm saying? Because I don't want to say he's the most dangerous, but a puncher is a dangerous nigga in the sport of ours.
He was the biggest threat, bro.
Mmm. See, that's not a scary nigga in you, brother. So you want to take out the nigga that can really whoop your ass.
But exactly. He was the biggest threat because he's been here just as long as me. Mm. If not longer.
Mmm. But then that's a dangerous decision because, you know what I mean? But you testing your wits and your skills and your pen, right?
That's not dangerous because even if I lost, that would be an honorable loss.
Okay, so that's the respect level right there. You know what I mean? Yeah, that's the respect level. You know what I mean?
I wouldn't mind seeing Young Ken in advance. You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
That's how the loss. That's how the loss were to be like, damn, Bill, how you lose that? Like, it ain't that type of situation.
At all. I've
been like, oh, okay, that was a respectable loss. Like,
yeah. So, but then when, cause I watched this shit live. You know what I'm saying? So, when the shit was getting judged, you know what I mean? When the decision came back that you won, how did you feel?
Yeah.
How did you feel, brother?
I felt, I don't know.
Mm.
Kind of like I knew already, bro.
So you felt in your heart you beasted him.
Facts.
Okay, cause so let's break down let's talk about some of these rounds real quick. You know what I mean? Since that's how you felt. You know what I mean? Because Cannon gonna do Cannon. You know what I mean? But Bill,
right?
The shit you were on. You know what I mean? The shit that you were on, I felt like it was a mixture. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like you was, man, dog. You know you can be bar heavy or you can be excited. What Bill?
I can do whatever I feel like doing.
That's a fact, G. You know what I'm saying? And the fact that you chose this route, it actually rap with this nigga, but still be Bill's cadence. You know what I mean?
Right.
I didn't hear no super duper scope. I didn't hear none of that, brother. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh. You give me a reason to rap, I'm rapping.
There it is. So, what is the reason for Bill Collector to just? Nigga, to rap, bro. What is the reason for you to want to rap, brother?
That setting alone is what made me say I want to be in this tournament.
Mm.
Because that setting forces y'all to listen to the rap.
Mm-hmm.
I see people still trying to make excuses. Oh, Bill has more fans, or Bill was a performer. What the fuck are you talking about?
Mm.
You, I was rapping straight through bars, everything, punches, back to back to back to back to back to back.
Mm-hmm.
They never give me that. I don't ask for it neither. I don't want it. You understand what I'm saying? But what I'm saying is, you know, they always gonna make excuses, but that setting right there alone is just like, it makes you rap. If you don't come to that setting to rap, you're wasting time and space.
That's a fact. You know what I'm saying? Because it's a quiet room setting. Quiet room settings, nigga, if somebody gonna make a reaction or give a reaction for your bars, it's cause you saying something crazy. And you're not supposed to react. You know what I mean?
Man, listen, Smack wasn't able to sit down, bro. He kept jumping out of his seat to the point where he just said, fuck it, I'm gonna stand up. He was going crazy while I was rapping.
No shit,
everybody
bro.
Back there.
No shit, cause you know what I'm saying? We can't see the other side of the camera. You know what I mean?
But you can hear them, niggas.
No, we heard him, you know what I'm saying? But the fact that Smack was standing up, you know what I mean? That's crazy.
They got niggas a little muffled and shit, but you hear the biggest niggas was going crazy the whole time I was rapping. And Young Cannon, like, he had him going crazy like the first round, but that shit got repetitive. So it was just like, you could tell the difference. You could see who won.
Out the gate.
Damn, it's a big ass building full of basketball, man. Fuck yeah.
So what you did was crazy because I feel like everybody I talked to, nigga, had YK winning, bro. YK,
yeah,
YK,
because I'm the boy you count out. You know what I'm saying? And anybody that had YK winning, bro, I don't know what the fuck they just want me to lose. That's how I feel. Because bro came in there, bro was rapping, but bro had a lot of dated ass Bill flips. He had all Bill flips, you know what I'm saying? And he had the same flow and cadence the whole battle, bro. He never improved. His style didn't change. He came in there rapping. Everything that I was saying to him, bro, was facts, and he was doing it right in front of me while I was saying it. Then on my third round, I say, damn, bro, you ain't say nothing about the Hitman show. I should salute for you. She kept, you know what I'm saying? Then I went into the whole Kate John situation that he went through and all that. And then he jumps right into the show out of Hitman shit. It just didn't look good,
that
kind
of canceled that shit out to the fans.
It didn't look good. But when he did that, bro, niggas in the room was like, like, it was one of them. So it was like, niggas don't understand. Niggas like, oh, he barred Bill out. No, he didn't, bro. He came in there. He said a bunch of dated Bill bars. And they was hot. Like, he did them in his way. But it was just shit that was said so many times, bro. And people tired of hearing it. Like, he said the Green Ranger, White Ranger, Tommy bar. Hitman said that shit, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just like, yeah, people don't pay attention, bro. Like, Hitman said a lot of this shit Cannon said. A lot of this shit Cannon said, bro, was said to me in, like, the past 3-4 big battles, bro. Leave on, babe. Oh, you can get my plate. Thank you. But, you know what I'm saying? You gotta pay attention, bro. I came in there 100% original Bill, like, always. You never know what Bill is coming. Everybody's always so confused. Oh, I didn't bet on you, Bill. Oh, I betted against you, Bill. Yeah, I bet you did. That's your fault. You know what I'm saying? Oh, I didn't know what Bill was coming. I didn't, like, well, stop betting against me, because no matter what Bill I bring, I ain't been the fuck losing. Have some common sense. Look at what's really going on. Niggas be like, oh, this guy is punchline. What? What else?
Yeah. Yeah, that's what it's saying, because you ambidextrous. Like, you're ambidextrous.
I do everything. Punchlines. Wordplay. Spoons. Metaphors. Over the head. Bring it back. Slow it down. Speed them up.
Hold on, nigga. Super duper scopes, nigga.
Super duper scopes. Performing. I bust a dance move. I do all types of shit. Catchphrases.
Yeah.
Everything, nigga. I am a fucking entertainer. It's deeper than being a rapper. A rapper cannot
talk.
Beat me.
Talk.
All these rappers y'all keep putting in front of me always lose.
What is it? So I want to talk to you.
YK got cheated. YK got cheated. How? When I had the fan vote and 4 random judges vote for me.
That's
all
fair.
Saying the same shit that I'm saying now.
Yeah. Hey. I mean, you.
I had the fan vote.
Yeah.
Of all the people that said I was going to lose, because I have seen a nigga that said Bill only won because his fan base is bigger. You sound stupid. Everybody voted for me to lose. I fucked up everybody's bracket. And he all said it. It was like 2 people that voted for me to win, nigga. So we're not going to say I got a bigger fan base. No, y'all all said I was going to fucking lose. Then what happened after the battle? I got the fan vote by 20%.
Shit. By 20, bro?
You understand? By 20%, I got the fan vote. It was 40-60. You understand what I'm saying? Then, unanimous decision by 4 random judges. All said 2-1 Bill. Niggas said, oh, here's another excuse. The third round was short. Don't y'all know that that's a big-ass timer right there while we rapping? Did y'all know that?
I didn't.
Did y'all know that we only have 2 minutes? And if I read the text right, 2:30 is the maximum, but that's really like you're only allowed to do that one round.
Yeah. So they only give you 30-second grace period for one round.
And I did that in my second round.
Okay. So that's like a timeout. That's like a timeout. You only get one timeout.
And they still let me rap because my third round was over 2 minutes. They still let me rap to 2:10 in my third. My third reported longer than my first.
Damn, they showed you love like that?
Fast. I ain't seen this shit looking over and rapping fast, trying to get my shit out. All these excuses, people, call out, man. Y'all look stupid. Y'all sound silly. And y'all sound like haters. I won. I can rap. Bill Clicker's actually nice, bro. I beaten quite a few of your favorites just off of the doubt and the hate. Please continue to doubt me. Please continue to hate me. Pray to God, I beg you.
It sound like this shit motivates you, brother. It sound like this motivates you.
Bro, this is... Thank you, man. This is what... This is how I be... Bro. This is what makes me pick the pen and the paper up. And the fact that I'm doing this shit for bro now... I don't know, man. It's over for a lot of these homies, man.
Yeah, because you're doing it for two people instead of one.
Right.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? You got I already know, bro. You know what I'm saying? When you got the spirit of your brother inside you, bro, you not living for one person no more, my nigga. Definitely with your passion. If y'all share that same passion, this is our passion now. He and me, now he going to help me to get where I need to, cuz I believe in, you know what I mean, spirits. You know what I mean? My man's spirit is in me, bro, cuz I got a dead homie, R.I.P. to my nigga RJ. He and me, bro, no homo. You know what I'm saying? He helps me motivate myself when I fall. I got an extra spirit, bro. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I know, bro. You know what I mean? So you really got to do it for bro, because he was trying to do it the same way you was trying to do it. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
So how you going to finish off this tournament? Boy, you got Mike P.
Hey, I got Mike P. And then after that, I'm
going to
have Wavy or Nothing.
So you speaking past Mike P, huh?
Yeah.
You said it so nonchalant. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Because I ain't going to ask what you're going to do. We're going to see what you're going to do. So who do you want after Mike P? What did you? Who was you more impressed by? Nun or Buddy?
Nun, of course. You know, I battled Wavy over here. I already got Wavy out of here.
That's a new wavy. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just asking, you know what I'm saying? Because what Nun did with Loso, because too many niggas don't get Loso the fuck out of here, bro. You know what I'm saying? I'm saying, bro.
Loso gets himself out of here.
Say it again, brother.
I said Loso gets himself out of here.
What do you mean, bro? Talk to me. PBV.
People forget that this is battle rap. And sometimes our star power overshadows our thought process.
Okay.
Does this make sense?
Yeah. Yeah. Keep going, bro.
I think in this instance, Loso kind of let his star power overshadow his hunger. In my opinion.
So you don't feel like he's hungry? Because he got to, you know what I'm saying?
I don't feel like Loso was hungry for that battle.
Okay, there it is. All right, for that particular battle. You know what I'm saying? Because I've seen Loso do shit.
I think Loso said the name Nun. I said, oh, okay, it's a cakewalk.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Yeah.
And I'm pretty sure Loso seen that name and said, okay, this is nothing. I got this.
He underestimated Nun.
Right.
Because what Nun did in his first round, and then how he transitioned to the second round, I wasn't expecting that. You know what I mean? He came to him like, you were supposed to do this for me. All this. And that second round, my nigga, nah, that's Nun mixed with the first. But it's Nun. You know what I'm saying? He got to getting gangsters. Like, it was a different type of animal. You know what I mean? In my opinion.
Look, I feel like Loso seen that name on the card and said, oh, okay, cakewalk. And Nun seen that name on the card and said, come up. Shit.
Yeah, come up, nigga.
It should come up.
Yeah.
I gotta go to work.
Mm-hmm.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
I don't want to say Saga did the same, but I think Saga kind of underestimated what homies was going to come here and do.
And they kind of like bros, my nigga. They like Gates of the Garden. They like, ain't y'all, like, shout out to Gates of the Garden. Like, I feel like y'all's a family.
Yeah, Loud Boys.
Yeah, bro, y'all's a family.
Yeah, homies. Yeah, okay, man. You already knew the vibe.
Yeah, I know. You know what I'm saying? That's why I was like, it was crazy to hear that, because somebody had to lose. You know what I mean? It can't be two winners in a bout, bro. You know what I mean?
Right.
So, you know what I mean? To hear what Holmesy did, I was surprised, bro. I ain't going to flex to you. I ain't a bodybuilder. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, man, I heard he did his shit, because I caught that battle like the second round. You know what I mean? Because I just came back in from, you know what I mean? You know how we do. You know what I mean? So, I didn't catch the whole joint, but what I'm hearing is he got busy.
Homie wasn't fucking around, man. You know, that's my bro.
I know.
He wasn't playing around at all, bro.
And that's love. You know what I'm saying?
He not playing with the EK nigga either, man. He already got like two rounds written already. Yeah. He had two rounds written that day that he just battled Saga.
Get the fuck out of here, bro. Two rounds written that day, nigga? That day.
I couldn't make this shit up if I wanted to, bro.
Fucking wild.
He already had them written.
Oh, he focused.
The bloggers and everything.
He focused, my nigga. That money bring the best out of niggas, bro. I swear to God, bro.
You shut all the catches out? Yeah. I think so. I'm seeing a scary cat. I'm cleaning mama's outside. But I got burnt out.
So,
I don't know.
I don't
want to
get out there.
Niggas know where they at. Where y'all at?
I'm on PA with it, bro. Or better.
Yeah, she
had the baby. Yeah, she got it, so I don't think she took them all outside. But it looked like, well, however she got out, they struggled to get out. They were all dirty, flustered and shit. So he must have caught the window or something.
Yo.
Bring her up. Yeah, my fault, bro.
Nah, it's all good, bro. I know you handle business and shit. You know what I'm saying? So, last couple questions. You know what I'm saying? So I got you on the line. You know what I'm saying? Because you're still an attorney. You know what I mean? Mike P. What did you think about Ryder versus Mike P?
I think Ryder won.
Why do you think that he didn't get the judge's vote and the fan vote?
You said what?
I said, why you don't think he got the judge's vote and the fan vote? But I feel like, bro, Buddy had a fire angle, bro, and his angle had truth to it.
The angle definitely had truth to it.
Facts, nigga. Shit.
We seen the emotions and the anger. There wasn't nothing fake about that. You understand? But I felt like, for one, you know, Beth didn't understand what was going on. Beth ain't been in the mix like that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He's like, he's watching this shit, but he ain't been in the mix. He's like, to know, like, oh, this nigga talking some facts about this nigga lady.
Yeah, he old school, bro. You know what I mean? Certain type of shit old school niggas don't go for.
Yeah, you know, I fuss with Beth. Like,
man, I know you do.
That's the OG, like, yeah.
Come on, man, nigga, you build, nigga. You fuck with all. Man, shut up, nigga. Nigga, I know.
Yeah, so, you know. So, I mean, I know how he move and shit, so I know he ain't know the situation. He learned after the fact when he seen all the shit on the internet, but fuck him. That's why he kind of got the judge vote, plus, like, a couple people was kind of, like, not feeling the way Rodham was just, like, harping on it.
Yeah.
He kind of went in on it for a few rounds. But all in all, man, he won, bro.
And I heard a lot of people say the same thing. Ah, so 100. I didn't know that was your man.
Bro, so I fucked with my shit.
But you ain't being biased either. I gotta ask you.
Every day and all that, but I fuck with him. You feel me?
But you ain't being biased, are you? Cause that's your man, right?
Nah. When they battle, bro, I sat on the floor right in front of them niggas to let them niggas know I'm studying both y'all niggas, cause I'm getting ready to battle one of y'all. Bro, 100. But I'm saying that Mike's my man, but that shit hurt his soul, bro.
You can tell. You can tell.
He was up there calling Ryder a pussy and saying, that's your front. That hurt.
Bro, when it comes to your female, bro, if you don't know how to or you never been through that, you didn't have a... You don't know. You don't know how to react, bro. You know what I'm saying? Because niggas from the hood didn't have one, bro. Every nigga from the hood and had one, if you know what the fuck I'm saying. You done had a hot girl, bro. You know what I mean? That made you nigga toughen up, nigga. We all had one, bro.
I was one of the biggest hoes from my neighborhood, nigga.
You know what I'm saying? But a girl probably turned your ass out, bro. It's a female, bro. A female would, nigga, do you bad and turn your ass out, bro. You know what I mean? But Mike,
I was a hoe from the rip, bro.
Oh, okay.
I didn't know no better. I had no common sense. I learned later in life.
It's all good, though. You know what I'm saying? Because some people are a product of what they've seen. You might have grew up around some pimp niggas, bro. You know what I'm saying? Because what I do know, it just...
I had Cinemax, bro. I was just
learning. You had soft core porn, nigga.
And then I went to college, nigga. I went to college when I was 16. It was lit.
Oh, so it went from Cinemax, soft core porn, to you actually doing hardcore, nigga. I know what to do with this shit now. You know what I'm saying? Because I was an HBO baby. I was a Cinemax baby. Fuck you talking about, nigga.
Bro, I knew how to eat pussy when I was like 11.
Young, bro. Real sex after dark, nigga.
Just started getting freaky around that time with the ladies. And then I went to college when I graduated when I was 16, bro. Man. I was in college with all the hoes, bro.
And then
lost my girlfriend, lost my high school sweetheart because I turned so old.
It be real like that, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? Once you learn something from TV and then they let you loose in the world, you become a whore, bro. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So that's real with that. That's real, you know what I'm saying? So what are you going to do to Mike P, no homo? 2 weeks. 2 weeks, right?
We're going to have fun, man. Mike P is a good dude, man.
He is, bro.
He's a great rapper.
He's very passionate about the culture. Like a lot of people aren't, bro. You know what I mean? Niggas look at him soft. I look at him as passionate. I'm not that passionate.
People look at Mike P as soft?
Yes, bro. Nigga, I be seeing niggas be talking Mike P like he's soft because he cried after the Saga battle, bro. That's passion to me, bro. But I won't do that. Say it again.
That was his soul.
That's him, bro. That's what I'm saying. That's him, bro. You know
anybody
I mean?
Think these dogs is probably nigga still on his couch, go to work every day. Mommy on that.
After giddy, bro. That boy, that was passion. You know what I'm saying? So you got Mike P. You know what I'm saying? Ultimate Madness 2. You know what I'm saying? Who do you want to see in the finals, brother? Who do Bill Collector want to see in the finals for Ultimate Madness 2 for that bag?
Myself.
Nigga, you can't see yourself, bro. Who you want to battle?
I want to see myself dead, man. I don't care who I'm battling, man. I don't even know who on the other side, man.
So you really don't give a fuck?
That's how I've been explaining to the nigga since day one. Nigga's like, dude, what do you want to do with the money? Give it to my wife. What are you talking about? It's $25,000, bro.
As you should, bro. You know what I'm saying? Happy wife, happy life. You know what I'm saying?
It's $25,000. We might get a new wall built in the kitchen.
He's like, so 25 ain't shit to you because you've been working with 20 and Mo.
Oh, yeah, bro. I guess. 25,
I don't
need
a
goddamn thing. That
should
be going about 15 minutes, bro.
Oh, well, shit. But, nigga, I need to get on your level, bro. You know what I'm saying? It's going to take more than 15 minutes for me to spend 25. I'm going to need at least 45.
I'm a homeowner, nigga. I'm looking at $25,000 worth of shit that need to get done right now. Just in my fucking man cave, just sitting here looking around.
Man, there it is, bro. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Yeah. I got these goddamn kids.
That's what I'm saying, bro. Grown man shit. Grown fucking man shit. I ain't trying to buy no watch. Nigga, I'm trying to get shit.
I got watch. I got jewelry.
Nigga, we see it.
Big boots.
We see it.
I got all that.
You know what I'm saying? That's all for. And niggas be so upset about my jewelry. I got an AP, right? I got a Frank Mueller, right? Everybody got all these stories and this thing and pull this out. When did I ever say, yo, I spent this much money on this? Never.
I'm saying, bro, if you get money, my nigga, you ain't gotta say shit. They
yo,
gonna
I
see
swear
you.
To God, every store I go in, bro, I might spend about $20 because they gonna be so excited to have me there. I'm just gonna take their pictures with me. Half the time, the motherfucker in the store don't even know how I am. Some of the customers say something like, "Yo, it's blue," so I take a picture. Niggas going live. But I'm an asshole. I'm funny. The same nigga y'all see on camera as I am 24/7. You know what I'm saying? Out and about in the world. Right now, I'm a little down because, you know, I just lost my brother. And plus, I'm high on all types of medical gas. Yeah,
high as hell. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying? The niggas gonna know who you are. You know what I mean? From your presence.
Yeah.
And what
store,
you do.
The store owners show love, man. They be like, yo, what's your Instagram? Oh, shit, you verified?
Yeah. I mean, any nigga gonna come here and spend some motherfucking money. Niggas gonna wanna know who you is. So, nigga, I'm gonna text you if I got some new merch. Man, hey, man, check these new diamonds out, man. You know what I'm saying? If you spending money like that, niggas gonna fuck with you like that. So, I definitely understand. But let me ask you this. Let me ask you this, you know what I'm saying? You being a battle rapper coming from the PG era, bro, and you still relevant and you can get money. Last question, what advice can you give to the up and comers? You know what I mean? Because you an old school PG nigga. Man, nigga, I've been doing this PG shit. Man, I'm still eating. You know what I mean? And I be seeing up and comer niggas, these niggas look broke. You know what I'm saying? I know how to generate a bag, my nigga. I'm good. You know what I mean? What can you say to these niggas? You know what I mean? To help them with their appearance. Like, niggas look dusty. You know what I mean? Get some money. You know what I'm saying? If you get money, man, what can these niggas do to get some money, bro?
You said it yourself, man. You said it yourself, man. In the words of my brother, LB the Boss, man, the late great LB the Boss, man, go get you some money, nigga. These niggas need to go get them some money, you hear me? Get you some money, man. You got you some money, man. You gonna look better. You gonna feel better. You gonna talk better, man. People gonna treat you better, man. Y'all ain't noticed when Bill Clinton got him some money. That's when the transition started. I started getting the plates. All I did was cut my hair, put the gold on my neck, got fresh, showed up to an event, got booked for 5 more events, showed up fresh to all them. They called me like, yo, you ready for Hitman?
That's crazy, bro. You know what I mean? So you feel like it's image based? Confirm that
super
statement.
Duper.
That was super
image,
duper.
Personality, your character. Don't just be the nigga that rap.
Say that one more time. Don't be the nigga that what?
Don't just be the nigga that rap, dog.
Yeah. Rap, just rapping don't get you no money.
Bro, I love my nigga Young Cannon, bro. But Young Cannon don't give a fuck about, like, getting fly, putting a drip on and all that.
Mm-hmm.
He just want to rap.
That's it.
You hear me?
He's a purist. He's the old purist. You know what I mean?
Let Young Cannon act him in there with some Gucci shit, some Balenci's on. Chain dripping, Young Cannon chain. Southside chain.
Yeah, it would have been a different. Yeah, it would have been different. I understand your logic, bro. You know what I'm saying? I like how you breaking this down because I asked you a question for
him to come
back.
He would have looked better. He would have felt better. He would have carried himself different. He would have talked different. He would have walked different. I'm telling you, bro. It's the same shit, huh?
Nah, money.
Everybody like, yo, bill collector, step this shit up. He is moved. No idea. Put some money in my pocket. That gold on my neck. I put that designer shit on. I make sure I keep a brand on me I'm representing.
Mm-hmm.
I walk better. I talk better. I feel better. I look better. You understand what I'm saying?
Nah, that's the shit that these guys respect, brother.
How do you,
They respect that.
How you feel when you broke, my nigga? When you broke, when you try to figure it out, because we all get there. Nobody is up forever and just like living life except for niggas that have been doing this shit for 40 years, like Jay-Z and them. Mm-hmm. Everybody take that L to where it's like, damn, okay, I'm back here. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
You know how you feel when you hear, okay, damn, I'm down to my last shit, aggravates. You know, we going to the club. Why y'all niggas always at the club? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, shit piss you off.
Yeah, man. I'm with you when you're right, brother. You know what I'm saying?
When you up. Preach. When you up, it's like, yo, we go to the club. Nigga, I'm already here. You know what I'm saying? You feel different. You talk different. You walk different. You feel me?
Yes, sir.
That's my best advice I can give to any of these niggas, man. But put some motherfucking money in your pocket, man.
And then niggas will respect you. You know what I'm saying? Damn, that was a movie, bro. What was that? Paid in Full?
And
you
no. Fuck how niggas feel about you. Because that's never important. You respect yourself.
Some people can't respect themselves unless people respect them. It's a lot of lost niggas in a different Lux type of theme. You know what I mean? Because I know a lot of Lux niggas, bro. It's like lost niggas. Like, bro. Like, just, like, you know what I mean? Well, I understand what you're saying. You know what I mean?
Bro, I guarantee you, anybody that think like that, that needs a validation of others to feel good, are broke. Let them niggas go good for money in their pocket. I guarantee you, they ain't gonna give a fuck about what nobody else talking about.
Yeah, to me, them niggas is hoes, bro. I don't need validation from nobody if I know I've been doing
it. Can't say that, bro. Can't say that. Might not be hoes. They might not, they just might be niggas that never got validation before.
To me, that's a hoe.
A lot of these niggas.
To me, that's a hoe. Like, no, you know, to me. To me, brother.
I used to think the same way. But I'm in the industry now, and okay. I'm understanding
I'm listening
more.
To you. Go ahead. Talk to me.
A lot of these niggas never got a chance to be a real nigga or a hoe nigga. None of that.
What
most
you mean?
Most of these niggas been rapping. Most of these niggas been doing this rap shit so long that the real niggas that they could have been or that was around them kept them away from the real nigga shit and so focused on rap that they were rapping since they was a kid, just rapping about all this gangster shit and you find out the devil or nothing about it. You think he a bitch nigga? He not even a bitch, bro. He just a nigga that's rap. It's weird. It's hard to explain, bro.
Nah, that's what I'm saying. I was about to ask you, bro, what are you saying, bro?
I know a lot of niggas in the game right now, bro, that rap about some shit that you be sitting there when they rap and you be like, and they ain't never been through none of that, bro. It's just that's what they've been trained to rap because that's they folks grew up.
Okay, yeah, that fake shit. That's what I'm saying. I can't even call it fake shit. Let me play.
Like, think about Lil Wayne, bro. Think about Lil Wayne,
bro. No, bro. Lil Wayne, because I can say this shit, and I might get crucified, but even Pac spoke or rhymed about shit that he didn't actually go through, but it was to reach people. You know what I mean? Because rhymes go deeper than you being through it. Yo. Yo. Yeah. Yeah, what I was saying, though, you know what I'm saying? Because you was talking about Lil Wayne, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Because Lil Wayne said a lot of shit he didn't been through, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? He's seen it. When you see it, you can be around it. Tupac did the same shit. And then he did go.
Yeah, that's true.
You know what I'm saying? No. Hold on. Check me out. You know what I'm saying? Let me get my bars off, bro. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because Tupac necessarily didn't go through everything he rapped about. You know what I mean? He didn't. You know what I mean? But his thing was, nigga, I'm rapping for the people because I feel their pain. I'm going to put their pain on me and I'm going to speak for them. It's different. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Like, Pac didn't go through that, bro. A lot of people don't go through that. But Pac is a different example because he rapped shit he felt, he seen. He was a narrator of his time. Do you agree?
Yeah, Pac don't count. We can't count Pac with these niggas, bro, at all. I don't even know how you got that.
Go ahead.
Possibly upset that we even talk about it with these new niggas. You understand?
I'm just talking about I'm just talking about what he stood for and what he rapped about. Yeah. He necessarily didn't go through. That's all I'm speaking of.
Yeah, but at the same time, Pac was still 10 times the nigga that a lot of these niggas that we talk about.
I know. I'm just talking about rapping, brother. I agree with you. I would not agree with everything.
These niggas that we talk about is allowed to buy tickets in the Tupac hologram show.
Say it one more time, bro. Say it again.
I said, I don't think the niggas that you talking about is even allowed to buy tickets to the Tupac hologram show.
I don't know who's allowed to buy tickets, but... You know what I mean? Because a lot of people are fans of Tupac for too many reasons. He didn't just stand for one thing. You see what I'm saying? That man stood for multiple things, bro. Like, he stood for women empowerment. He stood for, nigga, fuck the police. Like, that nigga flag would be multicultural. You know what I'm saying? Multicolored. Like, he just stood for too many things.
He's not doing that. Oh, that's what I'm saying.
That's what I... Go ahead, talk to me. Talk to me, Bill.
These niggas rapping lies. These niggas be rapping lies for niggas that they around or niggas that they know in the neighborhood or niggas that they been seen.
Mm-hmm.
And when it's time for them to perform in these actions...
They ain't gonna stand on it. That's what you're saying.
Now, flip side.
Got you.
A lot of these niggas... Now, flip side. You got a lot of niggas... Like myself, that use this, goofy ass rap shit to get away from the street shit and the bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
I spent the whole majority of the beginning of my life going to jail, in trouble, always dealing with the law. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
This rap shit saved my life.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it's like, you never know why a nigga move, how he moved with this rap shit, bro. It's just one thing that never accepted.
Yeah. Now, I understand your flip side, what you're saying, you know what I'm saying? But, like you say, everybody moves.
It's rope shit, bro. You ain't gotta be a killer out here. You ain't gotta be no gangster, bro.
Nah.
This motherfucker, this hip hop, man. These niggas on TV not really gangsters. That's why these niggas on TV, they entertaining.
Mm-hmm. Now, I understand what you're saying. You know what I'm saying? It was just that Tupac statement. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? So I definitely understand because what you said resonated. You know what I mean? Everybody don't rap the same. I'm paraphrasing. You know what I'm saying? Everybody don't rap the same. You know what I mean? But everybody, Tupac can throw a message out in his song Violent. You know what I mean? His first album. Three people gonna give three different receptions on that fucking... perceptions on that album, bro. You know what I mean? Everybody's not going to look the same on anybody's bars. You know what I mean? Somebody might take it as like, nigga, I got to go kill somebody. Somebody motherfucker might take it like, man, I need to chill out, bro. Or somebody just might take it as like, this is a dope song. I just want to listen to it. But everybody takes different to lyrics. You know what I mean? Do you agree with that?
Uh-huh.
100, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, yeah, you know what
it's
I mean?
Just like, it's just like something my old head told me, like, you know, the way you think you look to yourself, you don't look like that to other people.
That's fire, bro. Shout to your old head. Say that one more time for me, bro.
The way you think you look to yourself, meaning your physical look, your character-wise, any of that. That's not the way you look to other people. Everybody got their own music.
That's a fact. That's a fact, bro. You know what I mean? That's good game right there.
Some people think you ugly than a motherfucker. Some people think you Jew.
For real. You know what I'm saying? It's a flip side. It's always a flip side to everything. Like, what you think or what somebody else thinks about you. Somebody think, woo-woo. You know what I mean? Like, that's real shit. What? Oh, that just... Sparta, Wesley Snipes. I seen a Wesley Snipes interview. That nigga said, "Nigga, bitches used to think I was ugly as hell till I got that goddamn movie with the weekend white man can't jump. Now I'm cute. Right. Now I'm this. Now I'm that. Why wasn't I this when I didn't have that?
A man. That's what I'm saying, bro. Like,
I understand.
I wasn't nobody pop nothing. I wasn't in the mix of no hot shit. So I threw that gold on my neck, man. Now they got me battling these names.
Mm-hmm.
Now they got me running down on shit.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm bouncing top 10 on the ad, baby. Well, I don't know if I'm top 10 right now. That's just eventually every motherfucking day, but
you gonna be there, like, boy. That, like, you're the entertainer. Like you said,
nah,
you said entertainer.
That shit, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, I'm in the mix like Flea Sheet, man. I don't never stop Pete Diddy and them, you hear me? Like, I keep moving at all times, like.
Out the gate, you know what I'm saying? It's all respect this way, so I ain't gonna hold you up, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So, PBV, live this motherfucker with my bro, Bill Collector, you know what I'm saying? Anything else you gotta say to the streets, my boy?
Y'all already know, man, long live
LB
the Boss. You know what I'm saying? Go stream my boy's music, his name, London Baby. That's his music on all platforms, London Baby. We got songs out, we got some new shit getting ready to drop. I got some new shit out and all that, new song, Own Lane and all that, but fuck all that, man. Go see my brother, Jamie, and Bill Clayton vs. Chef Fred out right now. Bill Clayton vs. Young Family be dropping soon. Yeah, Bill Clayton vs. Chef Fred is out.
Wow, okay. I'm about to watch that now. I think I ain't know.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I need that to teach you. With the sticks with the ladders on them, you know what I'm saying?
I got
you.
You know what I'm saying?
That quick clap, your bitch, I need one of them.
I got you.
You know what I mean?
So we'll recap, man. I got you. I ain't know, you know what I'm saying? So I'm about to definitely tune into that. So, PBV, live to motherfucker with my big bro, Bill Collector, you know what I'm saying, on the slab, you know what I'm saying? Much love. Now, I appreciate you, brother, always.
You are ready, bro.
100. PBV, we out this motherfucker. Pussy.
My nigga.
Put your 3D glasses on, then, pussy, because you know we coming straight at you.